how are you, Johnny? Good to see you, mate.
Johnny, what?
He's a great bloke. Sorry.
Ah. Now, so, welcome, welcome to...
Yeah, I'll meet you there. About up past 12. Get through with this cockhead and we're right over there. All right, mate. Oysters and a steak. You're on, son. Sorry, Darryl.
You idiot. So, here we are for the second of the Bathurst interview series. And we're here with Terry...
T.
T. Talkers.
That's the one.
It's not really T, is it?
No, it's A.
A. Ah! Same, same.
Oh, this is what?
Daryl A. Ah. But anyhow.
Hey, in a minute, mate.
Fuck off,
there.
Wanker.
He's out there.
Anyway.
Cheap lights won't actually get out that far.
No, well, we can't afford much here at Vanarama News.
Bloody cold, isn't it?
Well, it's a bit chilly, but that's why we're sitting in front of a fire.
Yeah, but look at this. Looks like I'm smoking, which I'm not a smoker. I'm an absolute abstainer. Like drinking, but not smoking.
Okay, well, thanks for that.
Yep. Have you asked a question yet?
No, I'm about to ask one.
Okay.
So, I understand you're trying something a little bit ambitious this year at Bathurst. You seem to think that... you'll be able to get a Hyundai XL around the track.
Oh, that's pretty funny. I didn't expect you to say anything like that, especially since they're not a V8.
Exactly. Well, that's why it's a little bit outrageous. Okay. And, you know, the media, they're sort of out of control over it. But best I can tell, you're quite serious about actually winning the race in this XL.
Yeah, well, if I can just go back a little while to give you the full bottle on this.
Yeah.
A mate of mine, Johnny Riesmuller, who's a bit of a whiz with motors, said, look, why don't we try and get you into the Bathurst 1000 with a Hyundai? I said, you've got to be joking, Hyundai's aren't allowed. He said, not if we drop a V10 turbo into it. So we've relinquished the bonnet, the boot, and we've made it a
and the whole damn frame of the car.
Yep. We put 20-inch wheels on, a flow-through exhaust, a sunroof, no radio, and no power mirrors. And this little baby will do the standing quarter mile in about 2.5 hours.
So how have the practice runs been going?
Not very good.
No? What's the problem?
They won't let me on the track. Which is a little hard to get practice when you can't actually get out there.
Yeah,
so what I've been doing is I've been flying up and down the main streets of Bathurst. 87 tickets later, and I've been in jail for a week, and that's as far as I've got.
That would explain that earlier video of you, you know, with the no pictures and no comments and the stuff.
Me.
Yeah, that
well,
was.
I don't want anyone to find out.
So that was all related to your criminal activity in your souped up Hyundai.
Well, that was that as well, and I tried to pinch a box of tissues out of the supermarket.
Is that because you were sad they wouldn't let you on the track?
There was other reasons behind the tissues.
Fair enough. Did you clean up your mess?
Yep.
Good boy. Now,
especially off the dashboard.
We're working on it. So,
Make up.
So, Terry, so you didn't get into the top 10 shootout then, huh?
Oh, my God, I shot out.
Okay, well, I'm not actually sure that he's able to converse anymore. Maybe we'll call the interview quits now.
It's going on a high.
What? No. More.
Well, look, once we put in a disclaimer into CAMS, which is the Confederation of Australian Motorsport, and explain to them that really the Hyundai with a V10 was probably as good as Scafey and Lancers and all their $20 million cars. They go gave me a wild card. And then what I'm doing is running the drinks out of the flag motion.
Well, viewers, who would have thought that the idea of taking a Hyundai into Bathurst would have been so goddamn funny?
Did I tell you about the Forex girls?
And what about the Forex girls?
Well, they're very, very nice.
But
I got a mate of mine, Johnny Cadoggio. He's a bootmaker from Fitzroy in Melbourne.
Yeah.
He reckons he can give them better boots than they're wearing at the moment, because they've been wearing those boots for the last 3 or 4 years.
And right.
They're not.
They really haven't taken them off.
Oh, they haven't. They've got those. Oh, well, they've got. Obviously, they've got a little bit of tinny of a problem. But. and they're handy.
Is that what that smell was?
Well, I think it was. It was either that or the rotten hamburgers from up the road.
Yeah, and so about the boots?
The boots, well, I think they need a change of boots. While we're on a chain, let's get a little hand.
Do you think Leanne's going to have to pull in the pits tomorrow and have a pad change? Because her brakes might stop working.
I'm not sure.
Her brakes might stop working.
I don't think she's that hard on brakes. She's only got little feet.
Okay.
And, when you're wearing 6-inch stilettos, it's very hard to really push hard on the pedal.
And when you're out there driving around in your XL, will you be wearing 6-inch stilettos?
I'll have flats on, but I will have me suspender belt on.
Right. And will you be wearing a pink tutu?
Probably do. Actually, did you see Stoney the other day in his pink tutu?
Yeah, I think our viewers have been introduced to Stoney. He's not your co-driver, is he?
Oh, I wouldn't think so, but he's probably the guy that should be driving a Hyundai.
Who is your co-driver?
My co-driver. Now, interesting question. We've had a bit of a competition running nationally through Super Cheap Auto, who would like to, or who gets that
prize. Yeah.
So far, we haven't actually picked the ticket out of the box yet, but I'll do that now if you want.
Well, it is. I mean, what's the time? It's pretty late on Saturday evening.
Well, it doesn't matter because the person's probably pissed and.
Well, my point is.
He's sobering up by 8 o'clock. He's alive.
Yeah, yeah. You'd think you'd want to have this sorted out pretty early.
Well, you'd think so.
But you don't seem that worried.
Not really, because there's only one seat in the car.
Yeah, but there's okay. It's allowed to have one seat because you swap.
He's not actually going to be in the car with me.
No. You swap.
Well, you got to stop.
Yeah, you got to.
Once you get these Hyundai V10 turbo going, stopping's not an option.
No. So you've upgraded the fuel tank on it then, have you?
Yeah, the whole car is in fuel. we've converted the tub out of a washing machine, a front loader actually, because they're
big. Is it anything like this tub here?
Pretty much similar to that, except with
is it a wood combustion engine that you're running in there?
Well, it is actually. Can you see? This is actually a facsimile of what we're going to be doing. We've got to run a fire in the fuel tank.
Right.
That gets the turbo spinning, which gets the Hyundai up the hill.
Uh huh. And so,
once you get
up
the hill, we then coast all the way down again and start all over.
So you're running a
V10.
So this is like that's one cylinder of your V10.
That's it.
Is that what you're saying?
Well, the more wood we can get in, the more cylinders we've got.
Right. So it actually could be more than the V10, depending on how much wood you can get.
Exactly. Ask me about the brakes.
What about the brakes?
We haven't got any.
If you had any, would you have to change the pads?
Only if I was very hard on them. And because with Leanne's situation, she wears stilettos. I wear ballet flats.
Right, yep.
And braking's not a problem because we get up the top, come down the hill, coast all the way down Comrade Strait, and braking's not an issue.
Right.
I throw out one of my nana's old cast iron irons.
Right, so you've got an anchor.
Yeah, and that drags along the ground for a while, holds me up into turn number 23, it is, at the end there.
Yep.
And we start all over again.
Right. So then you pull the cast iron back in, you go back up the mountain, and then you chuck it back out again.
Do all over again.
And it's rinse and repeat.
That's it. Now, that's it. I'd like to thank all the sponsors, by the way. If I might say that, Darryl.
Who actually is sponsoring the Hyundai?
Batteries.
Yeah.
they're our main sponsors. The other one is Plush Lounge Suites.
Is that because you've got a couch in the back of it?
They're actually pulling in a couple of lounge suites for me, a unit in Parramatta.
Uh-huh, okay.
Should be good there. Get a couple of chicks around and make a mess of the old Plush Lounge Suite.
Right.
Well, it won't be plush once they're finished with it.
No, it'll be unplush.
It'll be very unplush.
It'll be, yeah, whatever the opposite of plush is, it will be it.
Plush. And my final one is Autobahn.
Autobahn?
Yeah. They make big buildings.
To put cars in.
That's it.
Barns for cars.
Barns for cars.
So they're not, that's not the, I mean, you've got the usual Autobahn. They sell the parts.
This is different.
This is the other one. Yeah, they.
This is owned by Jimmy Barnes.
Right.
Wow! And, yeah. He's a silent partner, if that can be possible with Jimmy.
Jimmy can't be silent. But as I understand it, the last plane out of Sydney is almost gone.
Exactly. And but he has built a new hotel.
Right.
That's the Star Hotel.
And it's got some flaming trees out the front.
Exactly.
He's headed to Japan because the rising sun stole his girl away.
And you shouldn't believe what Ida tells you.
No, because, well, frankly, she drives...
A Hyundai.
Yep. And you just can't trust Hyundai drivers.
Exactly. Got that little red light in the bumper bar. No, I'm not sure what that's all about.
Yeah. Well, Terry, it's been a pleasure to have you on the show.
Darryl, that's fantastic.
And I'll let you catch up with that guy over there that you were talking to before.
Who is he?
In the dark.
Oh, that's me makeup artist.
Yeah?
Oh, no, it's Johnny.
And, Johnny, that was right. It was Johnny.
And
good luck
on
the big day. Going to
need it.
And I hope you can get enough dry wood to power your Hyundai.
Well, there's going
to
be a lot of smoke and mirrors, let me tell you. And hello to the 4X girls, by the way.
Yes.
Hope you get some new boots.
Uh-huh.
And fix that tinier problem too.
Well, check you later. Bye for now.
Bye for now.